Now the next topic of our chapter is life history variation. And we'll be discussing about population interaction, but before that we should be familiar with this topic, life history variation. What is this life history variation? That means the population has different reproductive fitness. The individuals have may be able to reproduce in a different manner according to their habitat, and how is their R value, that means intrinsic increase jo hai, natural increase, wo kis tarah se, all will depend, and this will lead to their reproductive fitness. So a particular set of selection pressures, then organisms evolve towards the most efficient reproductive strategies. So depend karega unke habitat pe, and according to that they will evolve towards a particular reproductive strategies. You must have observed that some organisms breed only once in their lifetime. For example, bamboo tree and Pacific salmon fish, they reproduce only once in their lifetime, while others breed many times in their life. Most birds and mammals, some produce a large number of small sized offspring, whereas some produce a small sized but less number of offspring. For example, oysters and pelagic fishes, they are small sized but they reproduce large number of organisms, and birds and mammals produce less number of organisms of large size. So there is a great variation among these organisms in their reproductive fitness. Now we will discuss different population interactions. Actually, population interaction kya hota hai? It is what, ki how the individuals or the organisms living in a population, how they are interacting with each other and how they are depending on each other for their survival. The population interaction is basically depend on the species. They interact among each other in several ways. So there are different ways of the interaction. Interactions affect each or none of species. So this interaction is affected on each other. You know about ecosystem, all populations of different species along with their biotic and abiotic factors in a particular habitat forms the ecosystem. And we have also learned about the community, a self-regulatory natural system as a result of population and their interactions. So let's have an introduction about this type of interaction. You can see it is impossible for any individual to exist alone, hai na, akela koi nahi rehta. There is requirement of each other for fulfilling the activities of life. So when we talk about like interaction is important to fulfill the basic requirement of food, also interaction is necessary for plants also. Plants also depend on some abiotic factors like soil, water, and microbes are also there which help in the production of or in the growth of plants. So we can say that different individuals like microbes also, they also need other organisms for interaction. Now there are various interaction ki jo methods hain wo hum dekhenge. Interaction also affects the organism in a population to each other. Now there is an example of interspecific interaction. It is the interaction between population of two different species. Theek hai, interaction is required in two different species also. Suppose for their food, so they depend on other organisms for their food also. So this is called interspecific interaction. Now types of interspecific interaction may be of three kinds. It may be beneficial, detrimental or neutral. Beneficial mein both are benefited, detrimental mein one is benefited or other may be benefited or harmed. Neutral mein there will be no benefit or no harm. Types of population interaction dekh rahe, mutualism, competition, predation, parasitism and commensalism, and one more, amensalism. So we will discuss them in detail. Suppose mutualism mein both of them will be benefited, the bird and the flower both are benefiting each other. Theek hai, one is providing pollens, pollination mein help karenge, and the bird is getting the nectar from it. Another is competition, it is a negative interaction when the two organisms are competing for single food, then it is called competition. Suppose this wolf is also, fox is also want to eat that rabbit and lion also, so there is a competition. Predation mein, one is prey and another is predator, so one is harmed and one is benefited. So this is the predation. Then parasitism, the worms living inside our intestine, they live in the body as a parasite, and our body is behaving like host and our body is harmed, whereas parasites are getting nutrition from our body. So this is what parasitism. These are this tapeworm hai, jaise ki for example, so these worms are living in our intestine and they are getting benefit. Another is commensalism. Commensalism mein kya ho raha hai? It is a biological relationship between individuals of two species in which one species is getting benefit but other is neither harmed or nor benefited. Okay, so this is the process of commensalism. This is the interaction of commensalism. For example, ye fish hai and sea anemone, clone fish and sea anemone. So clone fish is getting nutrition or protection from the enemies, whereas sea anemone is neither harmed or benefited. Now, amensalism, it is a population interaction between organisms of two different species in which one remains unaffected and other is inhibited or destroyed. So one is affected, one is unaffected and one is harmed. Now we'll see, there is a table given in your book on page number 232. Just study table 13.1, which is showing. This is an example of mutualism. Species B, both are getting benefited. So, humne isko plus se denote kiya hai. Both of them are benefited. Competition mein, both of them may get harmed. Predation mein, one is benefited, one is harmed. Parasitism mein, again, one is benefited and other is harmed. Commensalism mein, one is benefited, other is neither harmed nor benefited. And in amensalism, one is harmed and other is unaffected. So this is the table with the help of which you can understand the interaction, population interaction. Understanding different examples which are given in your book also. In this, one species is benefited and other interaction is detrimental to other species or prey. So interacting species live closely together, results in a unidirectional flow of energy from lower trophic level to higher ones. So we cannot say that predation sirf carnivorous animals mein hi hota hai. Predation may be like ke, herbivore animal and plant. So predator ek herbivore bhi ho sakta hai aur ek carnivore bhi ho sakta hai. And it is a biological control, a living organism employed to kill another. Examples, herbivores, plant predators hain, jabki or like phytophagous insects, they feed on plants. For example, you can see prickly pear cactus introduced into Australia in the early 1920s caused havoc by spreading rapidly into millions of hectares of farmland. So actually this cactus was introduced, but ye itna zyada grow kar gaya ki sari jo farmland hai wo isi se fill ho gayi thi. So invasive cactus was brought under control by introducing Cactoblastis cactorum. This was an, that means the cactus was reduced with the help of this insect. So this is another example. Then predation maintains species diversity also. If there is no predation, then interspecific competition between preys will become more active and might result in the extinction of some. So predation is necessary. Another example, if all the starfish are removed from an enclosed intertidal area, this is given in your book also, then within a year more than 10 species of invertebrates, if we are removing all the starfish, to kya hoga, invertebrates ki 10 species bhi extinct ho jayenge because there will be interspecific competition. Predators also help in, they end up acting in reverse as well. If they start killing prey in large numbers, become extinct, the predator bhi khatam ho jayenge. So to prevent this, nature has put a check on such killings by equipping prey with several defense mechanism. So ab hum ye samjhenge, we'll understand that how prey are able to protect themselves from the predators. Theek hai? Just now we saw the importance of predators. Now how prey are able to protect them. So there are certain phenomena like mimicry and camouflage. Let's understand what are these. You can see in this picture the bird is there, but uska color kaisa, its color is such that it is not visible. So its surrounding is in such a way that it is even difficult for its predators to locate it. So this is known as camouflage. This phenomenon is known as camouflage, in which the organism or the prey is hiding itself. Actually it is not able to, its color is like its surrounding only. Another example, the monarch butterfly, which is highly distasteful. So it has made itself distasteful so that nobody eats it. Theek hai, wo apne aap ko bachane ke liye from the predator, because it has special chemicals present in its body. Ab wo special chemicals bhi kaise aate hain? During its caterpillar stage by feeding on a poisonous milkweed. वो एक ऐसा poisonous milkweed consume करते हैं जिसकी वजह से वो इतने distasteful हो जाते हैं. Lack of mobility has promoted the development of very sophisticated defense mechanism in plants. Now, as we can see, animals तो है, they can run away from the predators. But plants क्या? How the plants will protect themselves? So plants also have adopted some techniques. For example, they have developed thorns, poisonous or distasteful sap, so that nobody eats them, containing neurotoxins which may be harmful for the predators, nicotine, quinine, styrcine and conine. So these are the different chemicals which may harm the predators. So these are the mechanism by the plants, these are the adaptation by the plants which help them to protect themselves. Calotropis plant produces highly poisonous cardiac glycosides. This is why cattle do not eat this plant, or they do not graze this. Now the another phenomena is competition. Another population interaction is competition. We will understand the examples of this also. Species lose in their competition with each other, and none of the species is benefited. Now we'll see the examples. Interspecific competition. Just now we had seen one example. Suppose this is a prey, and this animal also wants to eat, and this animal is also approaching it. So competition is there. So whosoever will be the strong, it will be able to have this prey. Another example, competition between flamingos and fish. So between them also there is competition. So ye interspecific competition ho gaya. Similarly, zooplanktons. So zooplanktons are eaten by these fishes. So the interfering and inhibitory presence of competitively superior species may result in the reduction in the feeding efficiency of other species. That means due to the strong, the less stronger will not be able to get the food. This is another example, Abingdon tortoise. Actually the species of these abundant tortoise was reduced, yeah, they became less in number due to the presence of those goat. So ye bhi ek interspecific competition hai. The goat consumed all the grass and these tortoise did not get the food, that's why they were removed. Competitive release, this is another example. What is happening in it? Actually, in the presence of a superior species, this is another example, superior species ki presence mein, species that is distributed to a limited geographical region, matlab they can grow only here, expands its distributional range when the competitive species is removed. So barnacles, jo large barnacles the, unki wajah se jo small barnacles the, they were not able to be remain there. Competitive exclusion principle, ये गॉज की तरफ से था. This principle was given by गॉज. Two closely related species competing for the same resource cannot coexist indefinitely, and the competitively inferior species will be removed, yeah, it is eliminated. This is what competitive exclusion principle. Resource partition is another method. Ki, if the resources are distributed among themselves, ki being, some species will eat some another food and another species will eat some another food. So, this is called resource partitioning. So, this will help in the survival of both the species. If two species are competing for the same resource, they may avoid competition by choosing different feeding patterns. You know, that's what I said. So, if the different species are consuming different food, so they both can survive. Another interaction is parasitism. Most comfortable lifestyle, parasite lives inside the host and take the nutrition and also shelter from it. So, many levels of organisms show this parasitism, and it is beneficial for parasites, whereas for the host it is harmful, and host is constantly deprived and harmed. If the host evolves mechanism to keep the parasite away, the parasite also evolves mechanism, means ye co evolve hote hain saath saath mein, ki agar host ne kuch mechanism evolve kiya hai to avoid parasites, to parasites also develop some adaptations. So parasites have special adaptations, wo hamari body mein reh paate hain because of some adaptations like loss of unnecessary sense organs, loss of digestive system, high reproductive ability and presence of sucking organs, due to which they are able to take the nutrition. So, for example, plants mein common example hai cascuta ka. It lives on the another plant, it is a climber, it has suckers, hosteria hota hai inme, which with the help of which they suck the nutrition from the plant. So, we will see some examples of the parasitism, in which parasite is getting benefited whereas host is harmed. So, these are the examples of parasite like tapeworm, mosquito and Ascaris. We know that mosquito sucks blood from it and take nutrition. Different types of parasites are also there, ectoparasites and endoparasites. Ectoparasites take nutrition from outside the body and endoparasites live inside the body. So, ectoparasites ka example hai, jaise leech, it sucks blood. Lice, which are present in hair, and ticks in the dog. So, these are the example of parasites. Aur bhi hai, cascuta is also ectoparasite. Now, we will talk about the endoparasites, which live inside the host body and take nutrition from the intestine. Liver fluke is an example, which live in different host. Tapeworm are also endoparasites. We are familiar with the malarial life cycle, how it takes blood and how it uses our blood for nutrition. Another example of parasitism is brood parasitism. It is very important, you will be marking it in the book. Brood parasitism, in which cuckoo jo koyal hai, it lays egg in the nest of crow. So, what it does? It lays eggs in the nest of crow and the egg is hatched by the crow only. So, eggs of cuckoo resemble that of the host species in terms of size and color. So, here crow is the host and the eggs of cuckoo are developed there. So, this is an example of brood parasitism. Now, the another interaction is commensalism. One species is benefited while the other remains unaffected. There will be no effect on the other species. For example, bird and the flower, yeah, insects and the flower. In this, blood, bird is getting nectar दिस इज अनदर एग्जाम्पल, वन इज बेनिफिटेड, ठीक है, एंड अनदर इज हार्म्ड. तो डेट्रीमेंटल एंड न्यूट्रल, बेनिफिशियल, डेट्रीमेंटल एंड न्यूट्रल, थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ इंटरस्पेसिफिक इंट्रैक्शन मे बी देयर. बेनिफिशियल का एग्जाम्पल है म्यूचुअलिज्म, इन बोथ आर बेनिफिटेड, इन विच डेट्रीमेंटल में पैरासाइटिज्म, वन इज बेनिफिटेड एंड अनदर इज हार्म्ड. कमेंसलिज्म, वन स्पीशीज बेनिफिट फ्रॉम द रिलेशनशिप वाइल द अदर स्पीशीज इन्वॉल्व इज नाइदर बेनिफिटेड नॉर हार्म्ड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इन द स्टार्टिंग ओनली आई टोल्ड यू क्लोन फिश एंड सी एनीमोन. तो सी एनीमोन इज नाइदर बेनिफिटेड नॉर हार्म्ड, वेर एज क्लोन फिश इज प्रोटेक्टेड फ्रॉम द प्रीडेटर्स, उनसे इसको प्रोटेक्शन मिल जाता है. क्लोन फिश इज बेनिफिटेड एज इट गेट्स प्रोटेक्शन इन द स्टिंगिंग टेंटिकल्स. अनदर एग्जाम्पल इज, यू मस्ट हैव ऑब्जर्व दैट व्हेन द कैटल्स आर ग्रेजिंग, सम बर्ड्स आर ऑल्सो मूविंग अलॉन्ग विद देम. तो कैटल, इग्रेट एंड ग्रेजिंग कैटल, दे हैव कमेंसलिज्म. दैट मीन्स व्हेन द काउ और बफेलो आर ग्रेजिंग, सम इंसेक्ट्स आर देयर, दिस बर्ड विल ईट दोज इंसेक्ट्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ दीज कैटल्स. So this is the example of commensalism. On moving through the vegetation, the cattle stir up and flush out the insects, and these insects are consumed by the bird. So, ठीक है, see, you can see the insects are caught by the bird. So this is an example of commensalism. Similarly, barnacles and whales. So these barnacles are taking are living on the body of whale. In this relationship, barnacles are benefited whereas whales are neither benefited nor harmed. Orchid and mango tree. On the mango tree, this epiphyte orchid is growing. Now, orchid epiphytes are plants that grow on epiphytes kehte hain, but do not derive any nutrition from them. Kuch le nahi rahe hain, they are not harming to the mango tree, but it is getting support from the mango tree while the mango tree remains unaffected. So this is another example. So these were the examples of commensalism. Now we'll see about mutualism, different examples of mutualism. It is a kind of symbiosis wherein both the organisms are benefited. For example, very familiar example is lichens, in which algae and fungi are living together. Algae is preparing food and fungi provides shelter for both the components. Mycorrhiza is another example, fungus associated with the roots of higher plants. Fungus fixes phosphorus and helps the plant in absorption of nutrients, and it gets shelter and protection in turn. Plants also provide fungus with high energy nutrients. We'll see the examples of mutualism. Insects and flower. Insects are getting nectar from the flowers, and flowers will be pollinated in turn. So this is mutualism, that is interaction between both the species. This is what mutualism. So honeybee and flower is an example of mutualism. This we have seen, that nutrients are absorbed. Mutual association between fig tree and wasp. The flowers of figs are pollinated by a particular wasp species. The wasp uses the developing seed inside the fruit for nourishing its larva. So larvae are getting nourishment from the fruit of the fig tree. The wasp also uses the seeds inside the fruit for nourishment. It employs sexual deceit in which one of the petal of the flower resembles with the female bee in size, color and marking. So this is another example. mutual association between Mediterranean orchid Ophiris and bee. Now after explanation, I'll suggest you to write some important questions. First question is on page number 233. On the top paragraph you can write where commensalism and amensalism is given. Name the interspecific interaction in which one species is harmed whereas the other is unaffected. Okay, so you have to mention the interspecific interaction in which one species is harmed and whereas other is unaffected. So your answer will be amensalism. In this, one species is harmed and another is unaffected. Jabki commensalism mein kya hota hai? One species is benefited and the other is unaffected. Okay. Now, one thing is very important that you have to go through the chapter thoroughly. You have to read each and every example. Okay? Any example can be asked in the exam. Now, write down another question. At the bottom of this page, isi page pe aap end mein jayenge and here you will be writing the question. The question is, explain the defense mechanism evolved in preys to avoid overpopulation of their predators. Okay? I am repeating, explain the defense mechanism evolved in preys to avoid overpopulation of their predators. So we will be writing different mechanisms. So you will be writing point by point. I am giving you the answer. The first point you can mark is some species, from here, some species of insects and frogs are cryptically colored. I just showed you camouflage to avoid being detected easily by the predators. Some are poisonous and therefore avoided by the predators. So this is one of the point. Another point is on another page. Open another next page. Another point you can mark from here, monarch butterfly is highly distasteful. इन्होंने अपना taste ऐसा बना दिया है कि no one wants to eat them. The monarch butterfly is highly distasteful to its predator because of the special chemical present in its body. And the butterfly acquires this chemical during caterpillar stage by feeding on a poisonous weed. So you have to go through all the examples. All examples are important. Similarly, third point aap le sakte hain. This was the second. Third mechanism, thorns like acacia, cactus are most common morphological means of defense. Okay, so this will also help in to keep away predators. Then another example, the plant produces highly poisonous cardiac glycosides, that's why you never see any cattle or goat browsing on this plant. So these plants are not consumed by the grazers. Another example, these nicotine, caffeine, quinine, strychnine, opium, etc. are produced by them actually as defense against grazers and browsers. So these points can be written in this answer. Another question on page number 235. I just explained you Gauss competitive exclusive principle. So this is given on this page. Page number 235. This is here, Gauss competitive exclusion principle. Okay, so write down one question, state Gauss competitive exclusion principle, and you can mark answer here. It states that two closely related species competing for the same resources cannot coexist indefinitely and the competitively inferior one will be eliminated. So superior will survive and inferior will be eliminated. So each and every line is important. You have to go through it properly. Another question on the same page, in front of parasitism you can write, List any four features evolved in animals to adapt to their parasitic mode of life. So you have to mention the features which are adapted in the parasites to remain in the body of the host. So you can mark the answer. Parasites have evolved special adaptations such as loss of unnecessary sense organs, presence of adhesive organs or suckers to cling on the host, loss of digestive system because they are already consuming digested food, and high reproductive capacity. So these are the points. This answer. Come on the next page and write down another question. Here. State the type of interaction that exists between ticks and dogs. You can, you should know the answer. Ticks and dogs mein kaun sa interaction hai? It is parasitism. Then you have to explain brood parasitism. Just now explain with the example of bird, cuckoo and crow. So crow is the host and cuckoo is the parasite. Another question you can write in the topic mutualism. Mutualism mein leke name the type of interaction seen between figs and wasp. So answer is mutualism. Just one, we have asked one example, so you should know ki which example is considered in which type of interaction. So type of interaction seen between figs and wasp is, what is the answer? Mutualism. So children, many questions can be formed in this way. So we have seen all the examples and all the population interactions. I hope you have understood all the points properly. Keep revising and watch the video properly. See you in the live session. Take care. Goodbye.